which is, do we go forward or backward with regard to Cuba policy? And what's interesting is you just mentioned from the standpoint of travel. Think about this. You or I could travel to any country on the globe. It may not work out well for us, but you could go to Syria, you could go to North Korea, you could go to, I mean, a whole host of different hotspots around the world. There's not a federal government prohibition from us doing so. The only exception to that rule is Cuba. And so ultimately, as important it is to help the 11 million people that are, I think, enchained in a system of government that doesn't work for them in Cuba, this issue ultimately is an American issue about not only a farmer's ability to trade and to sell his product to those 11 million consumers, but more importantly, it's about the American notion of liberty, which is, you know, we're not the Soviet Union. You don't have to have your travel papers for the government to decide where you can or can't travel. We've always said, no, you get to pick. And so this is about upholding an American liberty wherein there's not an overwhelming security reason to do otherwise, to say that if an American wants to travel to Havana or to Beijing or to the Soviet Union, it ought to be their choice as opposed to being driven by government and Washington, D.C.
To Russia, you mean, not the Soviet Union. Very quickly.
Russia, correct. The former Soviet Union. Thank you for the correction.
The former Soviet.